Sorry, I've got to let the dog in. Come in, this. I used to try and roller skate up and down it.
Привет, я Бен Тавнер, и это London Blog. 2018-й обещает стать годом новостей от британских принцев. А знали ли вы, что тут живут не только британские принцы, но и русские принцессы?
Добро пожаловать в графство Кент, недалеко от Лондона.
Мы приехали в усадьбу, принадлежащую русской принцессе Ольге Романов. Да-да, именно так, с двумя F. Вот она, Provin the House. Hello.
Hello. How you doing?
Very well. How you doing? Very nice to meet you.
Hello.
Говорю принцесса, но конечно это по-английски. А по-русски она носит титул княгини.
First things first. How should I address you?
Well, please call me to my face, Olga. But if you're referring to me on television, it's Princess Olga.
Ее огромная усадьба раскинулась на 14 гектарах земли и насчитывает 30 комнат. Княгиня Ольга любезно согласилась показать нам свой дом. До краев наполнены историей.
This is the oldest part of the house. This is the core of the house, 13th century. I'm so sorry about the cobwebs, but in a house like this, the spiders are atrocious. So this is the 17th century oak room. Occasionally, tourists will ask me why is it called the oak room. And I have to say, with huge patience, actually, if you look carefully, you'll see it's all lined with oak paneling. Mm-hmm. That's my pa, who was born in 1897, just joined his regiment, and 6 months later, the revolution broke out.
And your father was born in Russia?
Papa was the only child of my grandmother's seven children to be born in the private apartment of her brother Nicholas II.
So that would have been in the Winter Palace?
In the Winter Palace.
Недавно дом частично отреставрировали. На его ремонт уже потратили около 2 миллионов фунтов.
And here is a portrait of my great-grandmother Maria Dagmar and her sister Queen Alexandra of England. That is myself, that wouldn't get off my pony, so the artist to pay me back put me in the boggin dress. I hated dressing up in pretty clothes. I still do. Dressing up in pretty clothes, and he made up the whole thing.
Wow.
So this is the 13th century bit, and we do events in this house, dinners and things.
Еще здесь проводят свадьбы и туры. Гидом на таких экскурсиях работает сама княгиня.
They like to come and look at the princess to see if I've got two heads or whatever.
How is it growing up and finding out that you're royal?
I was brought up with it. It was just me. It was just normal.
But you don't speak any Russian.
Papa spoke 5 languages, and only thing he spoke to me was in English. But he dreamt in Russian. When the nanny was off and he'd bath me and put me to bed, he used to speak to me in Russian. So there are, I mean, things that are quite useless, like lapa, and he always called me Dushka, and the things like that, which and da and yet, is hugely useful. Watch your head again. My great-grandfather, Grand Duke Mikhailovich, was the governor of the Caucasus. It's a quite useful little thing to prod someone with.
Княгиня Ольга – внучатая племянница последнего царя России Николая II. Неудивительно, что тут можно найти кучу вещей времен его правления.
And it was the china they ate off, the Nicholson family, when they were in captivity in Ekaterinburg, before they were murdered. So these trunks came out on the Marlborough. That was Ksenia's, my grandmother. That was Dagmar's, my great-grandmother's. HMS Marlborough was the ship that George V sent to the Crimea to pick up the unmurdered members of the family. Sorry, I've got to let the dog in. Come in, this. So we first went in 1998 for Nicholas II's funeral. And when we went to the church in Ekaterinburg, eventually they realized who I was. Then they got frightfully excited. And we had to come back the next day when there was an interpreter there.
Говорят, что княгиня Ольга могла стать британской принцессой, выйти замуж за принца Чарльза. Правда ли это?
I was just one of them that went up as a potential suitable bride. Of course I wasn't, because I was the wrong religion. She said I liked sculling. And I said, what the hell is sculling? And she said, rowing. I said, but I've never even sat in a rowing boat. She thought it was a better selling point than horses, because that's all I was interested in.